Yo guys, what is up? It is Nick. We are back on The Witcher 3 Blood and Wine DLC. Gonna finish up, never fear, Skellige's here, finally. Only four more. That'll be this episode. We'll also hit up the notice boards and read all of that stuff. And then hopefully...
Sir. What is it you need?
Had wine on my mind all day.
What kind? Red? White? Rosé? Dry? Semi-dry? Sweet? How heavy? What appellation?
I'll need to think about it.
Alright, what you got?
Show me what you got behind the counter.
She's got wine too. She looks like she has some different wine here. Just Chateau, that looks like... Okay, so we got those. We got that. We got that. We do not have Duke Nicholas Chardonnay. I thought we didn't. We don't have this. Did we? I can't even tell. It puts it at the bottom, doesn't it? Yeah. Alright, there we go. Alright, we are good. Alright, let's do this.
Tell me something about the area, would you?
What's there to tell? That the master of these lands, Monsieur de Bourbeau, is the greatest buffoon in all Toussaint?
Really? Thanks. Keep an eye out in that case. Gwent, maybe we could play around.
Defend Geralt of Rivia.
Alright, let's duel. I don't know what to call it, a battle, a duel, as you guys know what the hell I'm talking about. Okay, this hand is some crap. Get rid of... Oh my gosh. Alright, this hand is just some trash. Oh, he's got my Northern Realms deck. Or if it's a good Northern... You can make a really good Northern Realms, and there are times where you can make a really crappy Northern Realms deck. Like, if you jack around, you can end up with some shitty Northern Realm decks. Like, if he doesn't have any spies, that's a really bad Northern... The Northern Realms deck really isn't good, except for the spies. Now this gets interesting. What am I gonna do here? I guess I'll go for the win. Alright, he's gonna let me have the win. Alright, let's do that and just take it this way. Probably should have done that a little bit differently, but that's alright. Alright, give me my spy back. Dude, these trains, like, it drives me insane. Like, I can't even have my, like, I can't have my windows closed in my room right now. Like, it's just gonna, I'm gonna die of heat exhaustion. But there's, like, a train 24/7 on these tracks. I thought these idiots were gonna put an end to this. You know, I'm actually going to... I'm gonna do it this way. I'm gonna kill that spy in hopes that he revives it. That's what I'm gonna do with that. I'm gonna do that in hopes that he revives that spy back. That could have been a bad play. But I'm gonna do it. See how that goes. I'm gonna do this to see if he has another decoy in his hand. Does he? Nope, I don't think he does. He has to win this. There's no way he's winning it. My hand is stacked. And that really didn't help it any, but it's still stacked. That kind of hurts it a little bit, but it's still Rip City. I don't think he's got a shot in the world at beating me here. Actually, it might be closer than I should probably not get cocky. I'm not actually sure. He might actually... He's got a chance. Especially if all the cards left in his hands are freaking hero cards. He's definitely got a shot. Nope, that's it. That's GG. He needed to play some more than that. Those two cards in his hand needed to be something. They couldn't just be straight duds. Because I'm going to hit him with a nice, easy, quick, easy win. Or it's a she. You guys know what I mean. getting semi-rich off of this. Alright, three more cards to go. Let's take a look at the world map here. Where are we heading now? We're heading down here. I guess I can take a look at these right here on my way. I'm assuming I'm going to be too low level. I think I'm just going to leave them, actually, because I'll just go level up and then we'll take on that crap. So let me get this marker off the map. Come here, Roach.
Hey-ya.
She's calling my... Was she saying I was stinky or my horse? Can't be saying that. Alright, since I'm not going through the water... I think it's actually faster if I do this on horseback than trying to swim across. It takes forever to swim. Okay, we're riding through this area anyway. What level are these guys? 44? Yeah, right. I can't fight that. 44. Is that a joke? Are you kidding me? That is some ridiculous level 44, really. That's like new game level. Like new game plus level. That's crazy. I'm assuming I'm gonna definitely be getting a lot of experience. Like, I can't do any contracts. I really need to finish the main game so I can get experience and so I can at least be like a respectable level, like 35 or 36. If I can get to that, at least we're respectable and it's not too big of a deal. Like, I'll be able to fight and do all that different stuff. I can't even fight that. I'm 14 levels below them. Like, that is insane. I thought like the highest level in this DLC would be like 40. I thought like the beast that we're hunting, the main boss at the end, would be like level 40, but we got some bandits that are level 44. Like, what is that? There is a bulletin board here somewhere. There it is. Let's go read that first.
Wine is better than stew, for stew you have to chew.
Alright, I've seen ghosts. I'm looking for others who, like me, have encountered a strange presence in the Caroberta woods. I would like to discuss what we have experienced. Dagobert. Guide wanted. In my capacity as a scholar at the Imperial Academy, I have spent the better part of my last two decades studying ancient elven culture. My most recent research bears the working title, The Influence of Ancient Elven Architecture on Human Structures. Bro, that is way too long of a title. I'm aware the Caroberta Woods have been classified as extremely dangerous by the Ducal Guard, but to a true scholar, the quest for knowledge is what matters most, more than even life itself. That is why I seek a local hunter or knight to be my guide and guard. Serious offers only. Respectfully, Johann Neskins. Will buy bees. I'm a beekeeper, that is to say, I was until last year. A mysterious plague wiped out all the bees in my hives, and I won't stoop to stealing wild ones. If you've any bees for sale, I'll gladly buy them. Francois de Villar, I challenge you. You syphilitic scrawler of spurious slander. I've read your lampoon of my rhyme scheme theory and challenge you to a literary duel. If you have any shred of dignity and courage about you, come to the next soiree at Lady Oriana's residence with three poems prepared. We will recite in turns and then subject ourselves to the judgment of the literary men and women present. Not respectfully, as you deserve no respect, and no signature, as you know very well who wrote this message. Squire wanted. I seek a clever lad, one with a good rapport with horses. For a squire, as an experienced knight, I can promise whoever I take on a fantastic opportunity to learn not just the knightly arts, but also impeccable manners in the ways of high society. Gabriel de Pasternak. Horton's Vineyard closed until further notice. During an attack by hideous creatures resembling overgrown insects, the owner of Hortense Vineyard sustained serious injuries. As the threat is still present, Hortense Vineyard will be closed until further notice. Our sincere apologies. Oh my gosh, I need a drink after that. This reading is getting out of control. I got so much to read. Alright, let me pop open my Snapple here and take a sip.
Welcome to my humble establishment. What land do you hail from?
Been on the road so long, don't know how to answer that. Let's just say I'm from the north.
Ah, is it true what they say about the war, death, destruction all about?
Exaggerated. Not by much, though.
Oh, forgive my asking about thy family in Edirne, see? So I'm curious. But please, do tell me what I can do for you.
You can play me in Gwent,
what you're selling?
Let me see what you're selling first. You've got some wine, too. Do we got any new wine in here? What's this? A Mahakaman spirit. Looks like we have that wine. We've got that wine. I don't know why I'm collecting wine, but I am. We have all of this wine. Okay. Actually, I'm looking... Bacay with... Camembert. I kind of want to buy all that, but I think I'll loot most of that. Let's see about family.
Mentioned you have a family in Edirne. Where about, if you don't mind my asking?
In Vengeberg. You've been there, perhaps?
Yeah. Number of times. It's the hometown of my... of someone very dear to me. At any rate, pretty town, Vengeberg. Also didn't suffer too much during the invasion, from what I know.
Phew. That is a relief to hear. A weight off my shoulders, I tell you.
So, hold on, we'll let him say his spiel here and then I'll talk.
You play much Gwent? Up for a quick match, maybe?
Okay, so what I was gonna say is... I wonder if I have beaten the... This is another one of those cases. I wonder if I had beaten the game and ended up with Yennefer. Aw, you dick monkey. Oh, way to rain on my parade, dude. That dude's just out here raining on parades. But, I wonder if I ended up with Yen, if it would say my girlfriend or my significant other or whatever the heck they choose to say. Alright, so I need to draw a decoy here. Or not a decoy, I need to draw a spy. Or it was over. Spy. Oh, thank you. I appreciate that. Take that back into my hand. Okay, he's done. He's passing. I do have Avalok. Oh, I drew Avalok. Oh, it's Rip City for him. About to hit him with the hot GG. Could just Scorch, but no, we'll do it. I gotta be 26. Alright, we'll do it this way. I actually don't have as great of a hand as I was sitting here stupidly thinking in my head. This hand actually isn't as good as I thought. He actually has the same amount of cards left as I do, so things are about to get interesting, really interesting. Alright, that's what I like to see, thank you. That's fine, play that now. Alright, not bad draw. Alright, he's gonna do that. There's nothing I can do now. I can't revive anymore. Or I can't redraw that card anymore, so... He's gonna have cards up on me, so now things are gonna get really interesting out here. Alright, I'm just gonna Scorch. I'm trying to buy myself time so I don't have to revive. This is actually... this is not good. This is actually really bad. We might be taking our first L. I actually don't feel good at all about this. Hold on. I got an idea. I got strategy going on here in my head. I want two more cards. Give me a shot. Just give me something. Anything. Not exactly. Oh, you know what? Doesn't he have one in his hand? He's just not played it yet. I think so. So we're just gonna... This is going to be extremely close. This is fun. This is the closest we've had, so I'm interested to see how this goes down. Pulling ahead a little bit. Bro, you gotta play that spy, man. Help me out. Double more attack, alright. I can do that too. I'm not gonna do it now, but I can do that too. There's the spy. Still got a big card disadvantage to him. He's only 9 back, now he's gonna be 1 back. Oh, nice draw. Oh, okay. Alright, things are getting real interesting out here. Alright, so now he's got a 20. I hold a 3-strength lead. Hold the 3-strength lead again. He's gonna scorch, which... Why did he scorch there? Alright, it all comes down. Does he have another scorch card in his hand? If he has another scorch card, he wins. Oh, man, dude. So close. That's it. That's the hot GG. Because I don't have any cards left. He has two. So as long as he has... Yep. That's the first game we've lost. First one I've lost. I probably should have...
So nice to...
It's easy to say it now, but I should have just waited and taken the L on round number 2. I get greedy. I'm like, yeah, let me get the W here real quick. But I really should have been waiting. And then canceling my leader ability, that hurts. There's a lot of draw power between both of our decks here, so... Assume it'll be a little bit of the same this time. Yeah, there's the decoy. Play that, take a little bit of a lead here. Yep, play that back to me. I'm gonna see if he's just gonna pass. If she just pass... Okay, she's not passing yet. This is fine, I'm gonna hold still here. Not gonna play anything too big, but just gonna hold, chill out. Alright, now I'm gonna play a decoy. Because now the draw is way higher for him. Or for her, I keep saying him. For her. Alright, give me some more cards. Alright, I can decoy again. Do I need to decoy again, though? I'm going to. Just because. Alright, nice. I can still take the win. Let me actually... I'm gonna do it this way. Oh, nice. Nice. How do I want to go about this? Let's just... Oh, I have a 10 out there. I almost made the biggest mistake. Alright, let's do that. Take this round. He's gonna have the card... He has the card advantage on me. And now things get interesting. How do I want to play this? I don't have a lot of cards to work with here. So I gotta play this smart. I gotta stall as much time as I can. That's what the goal is right now, is just to stall time. Make him play stuff. Okay, don't have anything good in my... I'm gonna do this again. I'm just gonna Scorch again. Because it's all about just wasting time getting him to use that stuff. Right there. Also could put up a little bit of a formidable defense here. Get him to really play cards. Thank you. I'm gonna play one more. That pretty much cancels that out. I'm gonna let it go here. This is actually a really... This Nilfgaardian deck that she has is a really nice counter to mine. Alright, here we go. Final round. Got a card advantage to me at this point, but she could easily get some draw power still. There's a lot of ways. Decoys, revives, there's a lot of things that she could play to bring back stuff, so nowhere near having this even closed in the bag. So I'll have 8 cards now. Oh, nice. This was a beautiful draw. It's gonna give 9. Probably end up being 18, but I think... that wasn't as worth it as I thought. That's why I said, there's the 18. Here we go. Go with this bring back first. Alright, here we go. Here's where things get dicey. It's gonna be close. It's gonna be really close on whether I win or lose. I have more cards, which is nice. I'm gonna get to figure out this quickly. I am way behind, though. And there's a spy. That's interesting. So, 2 more cards for him. Oh. That's just really bad luck for me. That's just really bad luck. Horrible luck on my part, but... Not over yet. So far, his Scorch won't affect me. We're still good on that front. He does have an 18 out there. I'm assuming there is a Scorch coming. But as of right now... Okay, I don't have another revive, so I'm gonna grab him. Alright, my opponent... Okay, we got it. We won. I guess I'll play this for the heck of it. There we go. 145. That was a hard fought. That was a hard fought win. That was the hardest fought of the whole entire thing that we've done so far. That was extremely hard fought. That was a nice deck she rolled out there. I think it's time we switch up the deck for the last two. I think it's time we swap this. Let's go ahead and talk to Merchant Dude here. See what he's got real quick. See if he's got anything nice for us. What you got, homie?
Mind if I glance?
Yeah, mind if I glance at your stock? Alright. He does not have anything. Just back on out of here.
See ya.
I want that mustache. Can I have that mustache?
Hey, what's that?
Let me see what you got.
Mind
to
showing
sell.
Me your wares?
What you got? This is gonna be a longer episode because we're finishing the stupid Gwent crap. Yeah, we're finishing it in this episode. Alright. We're at 24
Gwent.
Minutes.
Interested in a round or two?
Yo, that haircut, though. That haircut, though. I can't believe it. Do we want to roll a Scoia'tael deck out here? We can't roll. We're not rolling out a Skellige deck because we're going to play that tournament with it. Let's go Monster. What haven't I used? We've been using Nilfgaard and Northern Realms. We can use Scoia'tael for one. And let's use Scoia'tael for this one and we'll use Monster for the last one. I probably should have been switching it up a little bit more, but I... Oh, crap. I wasn't paying attention. Oh, well. Yo, these trains have me straight shaking my head. I can't believe it. It's ridiculous out of here. Let's ditch a Scorch. Actually, let's stop right there. Alright, well. That one Triss did pretty much everything. Alright, let's just pull this in. 15. We're barely doubling up. Here we go with the spies. Alright. This is not a good start. Oh, great, a Scorch. Thanks a lot for that. Fine, I'll play my Geralt. Counter your Ciri. He's like straight going for the win here at the beginning. Zero Fs are being given. Actually, let me do this here. Oh my gosh. I'm about to take an L and we're like barely into this. I've used so many cards. This is effed up, man. Alright, would you please just pass? Just pass. You SOB. Well, I don't like this deck. I didn't change my hero or my leader either. That was a mistake. Probably gonna lose here. Oh, that was a clutch draw, even though it's gonna be close. Oh, okay, great. This might actually end up being a little bit closer. Alright, so there's that. Oh, do I play my Scorch now? I'm gonna do it, I'm gonna play it. Oh, well, there's the hot GG. There it is, that's the GG. Yep, I can't win, that's the GG. Unbeatable Barkins. That was great. Alright. Let me change my leader this time. Because I don't care if I go first or second. That doesn't matter to me. So that's a crappy leader ability for how I play this. Oh, draw an extra... Oh, okay, maybe I had a different ability on. Double strength all close range. Okay, never mind. Let's do this. Actually, yeah. Okay. Scoia'tael okay, let the opponent start. Alright. Well, this hand is some bukkake, but... Let's do it. Oh, of course. I can't win, dude. I can't win for nothing. Oh. What, man? What am I supposed to do against... Are you effing kidding me with this? Yo, this is just straight stupid. Getting like straight cheated out here. Yeah, with all the spy. I don't have any revive. Yeah, I'm taking an L. We're just calling that. I'm just taking the L on that. I had nothing. Like. Like, you gotta be kidding me with how I'm losing these. This is stupid. See, this is why I play the decks that I like. This is why I don't play these. Because, for one, I suck with them. And for two, it just never works out. Okay, there we go. Finally, I drew Avalok. And I have some revive power. Okay. Alright, not bad. Okay, there's some revive power, nice. This has quickly become an interesting start. How do I want to play this? I'm gonna do it this way. Alright, he's gonna decoy. Man, I shouldn't have made fun of this dude's haircut. Getting the wrath of God from him now. Let's go ahead and do this. If I lose this here, we're switching to the Northern Realms deck, and I'm just gonna smack this dude. Homie, you gonna play that spy that you got back, or are you just gonna hang out with it in your hand? Like, really? Play the card. I hate you. Play it. Of course. Here we go, you gonna play another Scorch? Okay, thank you for playing that card. Now what do I do? I'm gonna force him into passing. I think that's enough of a gap. Okay, we're not passing yet. Alright, dude, this is enough. Really, we're doing this right now? You really want to do? Well, this is bad. Alright, we're still doing this. He's not backing down. There's no back down in this dude. Yeah, pass. Finally. Alright, now things get interesting. Okay, I have two of those right. Okay. Wow, that couldn't have gotten much better of a draw right there. 25 power right there. That's up. Let's see here. What are we drawing now? Alright, that's not as good, but I'll take it. Ooh, this might get close, depending on what the last card is. Actually, no, I got this in the bag. Unless that last card's a spy, yeah. GG. Finally. That was
Justin,
embarrassing.
Jewel-encrusted Galligaskins, the latest rage.
This is gonna be a clan Drummond shield. This is definitely gonna be like a 40-minute episode, like 50-minute episode, probably, at this point. Bro, why are you coughing like that? I need the fast travel because I can get closer than where I am now. Where the heck is it? Oh, really? It's on the complete opposite side. Yeah, because I'll be able to fast travel to here. Alright. I won't read any of the bulletin in this episode. We'll go ahead and do that in the next episode. I will read.
Ah! No, Pickard.
Alright. So, let's go... Let's actually come this direction so I can hit that. And then hit that in the next episode, and then we'll go down and hit that one, and we'll have all the bulletin boards red. Alright, Roach, let's ride. Let's finish this quest. I didn't think it would take this long to do this quest. This is kind of crazy. Oh, why did it tell me to go up there then? If I could just go this way. Oh, because, you know, there's a river here. Come on, game. Can I cross this bridge? That's a tight squeeze on a horse. Alright, 500 units of... I always have to call it that. 500 units of measurements away, whatever the game measures. Because some games measure it... There's a vineyard infestation. I can't do that right now. Some measure it in feet, some measure it in meters, some measure it in, like, a... Not miles, but some measure it in, like, not inches. I don't know what I'm trying to say, but the different games measure their units in different measurements, and sometimes it's just like their own made-up measurement, like, you're this far away. Alright, here we go, though. Final card. Let's get it. We're gonna be using the, monster deck. To finish this all up. Hopefully I can win with the monster deck.
My elf.
Oh, I need to go on the other side. Alright, herbalist.
Welcome, wanderer. In need of herbs, perhaps? Wort for a sore stomach, or...
Prefer willow bark or iris root for stomach aches. Word can cause dizziness, nausea.
Forgive me. It's just that you do not have the look of one familiar with herbs.
What looks that? And looks deceive, anyway. Me, I'm not out for common weeds that grow in any meadow. Need rare ingredients. Can you help me out, or should I move on?
You must judge for yourself.
Right. Show me what you got.
She's got some different, she's got like superior stuff and decoctions, wyvern and nectar. All right, let's actually, hold on. Can I make anything new? I don't think I can. I haven't like picked up any new items, but who knows. Okay, no, 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 and no. Okay.
Meant no offense.
And I took none. I should be the one to apologize, for judging by appearance alone. Tell me, your knowledge, how did you gain it? From an herbalist living nearby?
No, from somewhere a long way off. Kaer Morhen, northern Kedwin.
Gods! That's the continent's other end. What are you doing in Toussaint?
Same thing I do anywhere. Killing monsters.
Alright, let's do this. Final Gwent game of this quest.
Wouldn't happen to play Gwent, would you?
The aroma.
And it's the Monsters Lovely. Deck, which I have actually never played. I have never used the Monsters deck. Restore a card from your discard. Discard two cards and draw one. Double the strength. Yeah, I want the restore a card. Please play. Alright, Nilfgaard. Nice. I'll take it. Alright, actually, these are. Okay, I will put you back in the deck. Nice. Okay, this is a really good hand. I like this hand. Do this. Alright, homie just straight passing already. I don't know what that was. That was a weird start to this. Not a whole lot of power there, but some cards out on the field. I'm just trying to get them to play cards here. See if I. Okay! Well, oh, that's bad. Go. That's the real power right there. Alright, I'm gonna end my turn here. Alright, you can see the three cards in my hand. There's not much there. What just happened? What the heck? Alright, well, Clan Bro Kavar Archer. I have a Gwent problem. Collect all the cards in the Skellige deck. I do have a Gwent problem. Let's go ahead and take a look at this deck, and then we'll call it an episode. That is a fitting achievement for that quest. Alright, Skellige deck. Alright, so obviously we need to throw in the basics, the hero cards that I have. Along with Avalok. And then Hjalmar. What is this special for Cirrus? Summons all shield maidens. Okay, so we need shield maidens in our deck. What does this do? What does Ermion do? Triggers transformation of all berserker cards on the same row. Okay, so we need that. We definitely need Olaf, because that's a high damage. Where are the shield maidens? We gotta make sure we get those in first here. Okay, here are all the shield maidens. Let's pull them all into the deck. We've got Birna Bran. There's a revive power. A Cambi. Summon Avenger. When this card is removed from the battlefield, it summons a powerful new unit to take its place. Let's bring that in. Let's bring these three with us. Bring you. Bring the young Berserker. Wait, hold on. Where? He's an archer, so yeah, that's actually okay. To a bear. I don't have the other bear cards, though. Kill the strongest cards on the battlefield. Okay, I like that. Let's bring that into the deck. Here we go. I like this. Give me these cards into the deck. Okay, we got way too many unit cards. I need to figure out what to drop. But Mardrome triggers transformation of all berserker cards in the same row. I will put one of those into the deck. Two decoys, two commander's horns, Oh crap, I screwed up. Give me one of those commander's horns back. Okay, so we gotta get rid of some monster cards. Anything here that sucks that I can get rid of? I don't really think so. This might just be a deck with a little bit more cards than... Let me get rid of Cambi. I don't need him in my deck. But this could just be a deck with a little bit higher number of cards available in it. because I think that's what fits best. I guess we... No, I like the ability to pull those back into my hand. Yeah, this is just going to be a higher numbered card deck at 35. It's going to have 5 more. It actually has 6 more than I usually have in my decks, but I think this works out fine. How many of those Berserk? I only have like one of those Berserk. Let's get rid of this card, cut the deck down a little bit. But that is going to do it for this episode, guys. We have completed the Skellige deck. I hope you guys enjoyed. Drop a like if you did, subscribe if you haven't, and I will catch you all in the next one where we will be doing something other than Gwent. So peace out.